emphasis on cutting-edge domain knowledge and benchmarking with world-class businesses.
Big Tech. Today we had with us Dr. D.K. Garg, Chairman of Ishan Ayurvedic Medical College and Research Center. Sir, we would like to ask you some questions. Sir, what's your motive behind this?
Ayurveda is a natural science. Since by birth, we are associated with Ayurveda directly or indirectly. Ayurveda is a science which enables us to improve our immunity power, to maintain ourselves. Since birth, we know thanda garam kya hai, garam roti ke baad thanda paani nahi peena hai, garam paani ke upar thanda nahi lena hai, aur kis mausam mein kya nahi khana hai, doodh ke baad dahi nahi lena hai. It is in our blood. But this science is very much ancient. It is from Samveda. According to the Samveda has prescribed the different kind of treatments for the body. In fact, Ayurveda is basically related to improvement of immunity power by using the herbs, plants and trees. We believe that trees and plants are creation of the God, and everywhere there is an existence of God, and the God has prescribed us the different kinds of treatment, because human life is 400 years or plus, it can be a plus. So once we do something wrong in our body, then immediately the God provides us other treatment. So if we are capable to explore this opportunity, this is called Ayurveda, for improvement of health system and immunity system.
What challenges did you face while bringing this innovative course in Greater Noida?
In fact, the first challenge is we are always in hurry. If there is a headache, we believe take a small tablet, headache is over. But if I'm in Ayurveda, we have to see what are the root cause of headache. We have to analyze and how this root cause can be removed. Because indirectly, if there is something wrong in my nail, cutting the nail is not a solution. I have to feel that there is a doctor inside my body, and I have to use that doctor. I have to make that doctor capable for this. So this is one of the challenges, that the people who come to me for discussion about Ayurveda, they are in very much hurry. They ask, kitne din mein jaldi se theek ho jayega? Aap hamare baal safed hote hain, it takes long years. Aankhon pe chashma lagta hai, it takes long years. Every disease takes very long years. When our body is failed to cure the disease, so similarly, the treatment will also take time. So the first of all, the patience of the person is a challenge. Number two challenge is the good kind of Ayurveda medicines are not available in the market. There is no proper shop, there is no proper place where we can purchase the Ayurvedic medicines for the person. Then number third challenge is getting a license, getting a prescription done for a pharmacy. Is also very tough task, because a lot of corruption, lot of hurdles in this. Because if I want to develop some generic medicines, then I will face a lot of troubles, lot of problems. These three things are very big challenge for me. So this is why I am unable to develop the good medicines for the people based on my 100 years in science.
Sir, what is the duration of each course and the process of taking admission in the same?
You are asking about the admission BAMS course. It is a course of 5.5 years, equivalent to MBBS. So admissions in this course are conducted by the government of Uttar Pradesh by way of counseling. And once the students who apply through counseling come to the college, it is a procedure. Directly we cannot take admission. Seats are fixed by the central government.
What are the major elements treated here, sir?
No, we will specialize ourselves in this hospital to treat the cancer, to treat the ulcer, to treat the skin diseases like psoriasis, and to treat the asthma, and to treat the TB. We will specialize this hospital, apart from the routine medicines, routine checkups.
So when we talk about hospitals, one of the most important thing is that affordability. So how affordable this college will be for common people?
In fact, our trust has contributed too much in this hospital. We have taken bank loans and we have personally invested from our family funds to make this dream successful. Initially, it is not a profit making organization because for opening Ayurvedic college, you have to invest again and again. I think up to last next three, four years, there will be no revenue, only losses there. If you will talk in terms of finance.
Sir, a lot of people have a lot of misconceptions about Ayurveda. So what's your take on that?
In fact, those who criticize Ayurveda, they should read what is Ayurveda. And they should discuss with open mind about the Ayurveda. If they will read, they will discuss, then they will realize that Ayurveda is the only thing. One person, I will quote one example of my relative, was in the hospital for 15 days due to cough. I advise him very simple, take Molati and then you feel relaxed. He started taking Molati, now he is outside the hospital. So people realize when their pocket is empty. People are rich, they will criticize the Ayurveda because they want to a good show off. You see hospitals and so many nurses surrounding them, this thing.
So what's your vision about future?
My vision is to develop at least 3-4 patents annually. At least 3-4 patients to develop a good research center. And we will publish a research magazine. Our first episode will be on spinal cord, cervical, backbone pain and different kinds of pain. Next, our vision is to publish the books on Ayurveda or different kind of treatments. Our 15 books are almost ready, and in January we will request our Honorable Dr. Mahesh Sharma ji to release all such things. It is our first vision.
Thank you so much, sir, for talking with us.